There is Alfredo Evangelista. He's been in the ring for a while, and the champion keeping him waiting here at Capitol Center just outside of Washington, D.C., in about 45 miles. And the champ now is getting ready to leave his dressing room and come out here before 12,000 fans and all of you. A prohibited favorite. Remember, when he won the title from Michigan, he was a 7-1 underdog. Jim Braddock was a 10-1 underdog when he beat Max Fair. Well, something you can think about, but only 22-year-old Evangelista has very few bouts. Only 16, as a matter of fact, losing one. He's affable enough in the ring, greeting everybody. Big legs, longest trunks we've seen. Just like many of the European fighters and sports competitors, they wear billboards on everything. And of course, the big thing here is to see the champion who weighed in at 221 and a quarter pounds. His first bout since the Penn Run Emergency Stadium affair, September 28, 1976. Great champion. Ninth title of the match, looking for his position after a layoff in the back, but only a few weeks ago, Muhammad Ali at home run looking. But losing, he looked really out of shape, but he's trimmed a lot of weight off. And he's got a lot for the game. Great athlete. Loving every minute outside the ring. You don't think he has hangers on and powers? You can count on it. There is not a man of another world's one. And now the Latin American tempo has changed a little bit to the rock and roll for an American boxer, of a United States boxer, Muhammad Ali, and Howard Soldier Tapping, waiting for the scheduled 15 rounder.
Thank you very much, Chris. Yes, there's a lot of noise in the Capitol Center in Landover right now. The background music motif has changed completely. Earlier we had Latin American music on Alfredo Escalera and dispatched Carlos Cossero did a dance. There's Joe Lewis. He's invariably around at a heavyweight championship bout. Joe is not young anymore, as you can see. Somehow there seems to be a sadness in the face. He's not been in good health, but he seems to be recovering now, which, as you know, it sees his balance in Las Vegas come out. As Ali makes his way through the crowd, they stand, some seek to throw at him. It's an old familiar scene to the man who said he was retiring, went to Turkey and announced it, then Buchanan, then re-announced it, then Buchanan again. And now he goes against the unknown, totally unheralded, indeed nationally banned youngster. There's Jimmy Young, who in my book is one fine boxer. There's a kid who knows how to use a ring and skin boxer. His victory over Foreman was great, and he gave Ali what they are on April 30th a year ago, even though the officials gave Ali the victory. That's the Evangelista is as bad as everybody says, and the only thing we can find out in tonight's fight, hopefully, is how much does Ali have left. And this fight will be starting shortly. Right now, Evangelista looks squeezed up, and as lathery as Seattle Slew did before the derby. We'll be back. We're back live at Landover, Capitol Center. This crowd has gone crazy. They stood as one. There are about 12,000 of them. They were chanting, Ali, Ali. Say what you want. Go back through all the years. Agree with the man. Disagree with him. He is a world figure. He does transcend sport. He's a figure not just of athletic history, but of legal history, too. And they're here to see him and throw in sociologic history, too. This fellow has had some impact, a major impact on every avenue of the society. You're looking now at his record, 53-2, 37 KOs, the two losses, March 8, 1971, to Joe Frazier,
and of course Kenny Martin, March 31, 1973, when Kenny broke his jaw. Evangelista has had 16 fights. He did lose, as we pointed out in our journalistic piece on the rating procedure of the WBC and the WBA. In his case, he lost to Lorenzo Zainon, an unrated fighter, not in the top
20.
Ali at 221 and a quarter. Evangelista, just 22 years of age, weighed in at 209 and a half. As you tell on the tape, 13 years age differential. There's nothing in the record of Evangelista that would document his ability to meet a fighter like Muhammad Ali. The height, I think, is grossly overstated of 6'2 for Evangelista. He looks closer to 5'10 to me. He has virtually no neck. Reminds me of the one-time Chicago White Sox and New York Yankee ball player, Walt No Neck Williams. There's Ali right there. And again, as you look at the tail of the tape, Evangelista's waist 2 inches larger, his thigh an inch less. The calves are about the same. The ankles measure reasonably the one against the other. Ali, amazingly, down to 221 and a quarter, as I said. And I say amazingly because when I was with him at the press conference announcing the fight, he looked about 245. When I was with him before that in Los Angeles, and there is Ali giving Evangelista a stare. Instructions which couldn't be clearly heard from the referee, who was Harry Cicchini. The judges of Terry Moore, Ray Klingmeyer, again starring down here in a 5-point mark system. We're about ready to go. 8-ounce gloves, 22-foot ring. I was saying that Ali down incredibly to 221 and a quarter. Nevertheless, as I pointed out in my other interview with him, carries a fresh roll about the left. Evangelista stumps. He's in the green. The dog goes down to his knees almost. Now let's see what, if anything, he can do. Ali on his toes. Jamming the crowd with the double shot. Hanson hands it aside. That's because of the nature of the opponent. He himself admits the hands aren't as fast as once they were, neither are the feet. The stamina is suspect. Well, he did go 15 rounds against Dalton on September 28th last year on Yankee Stadium. Evangelista threw a left and missed. Well, we're having an entertainment show. Evangelista is dancing in time with Ali. This kind of sense of humor is apparently not necessarily all. First round action, if you want to call it. Ali dancing. Ali shot with two lefts. And here the Ali snort as he throws the blows. First round dance session. A couple of quick leg jams by Ali. Missed by Ali with the left, a push off with the left on the part of Evangelista. Such things would not necessarily normally be mentioned, but that's about all we're getting here. Other than a Rogers and a Stanley, please. Here's the action, and Ali elects to entertain the crowd in a different way. Coming down to the end of the first round. There's the rope-a-dope on the cover up. Evangelista couldn't get through it. First round has established exactly nothing. It's been a vaudeville act.
We'll be back in a moment.
Around Joe, as you look at Alfredo Evangelista, here Brian Bond, now Spaniard, who is getting a chance to fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. Now he looks like a bullfight, moving that left foot, landing it in. Crowd is not so elated. They'd like to see some action. Well, letting that fact be known both of them. I'd put to a judgment, I'd say this is just a cut above thus far. It's only an Oki affair in Tokyo. Now they went against the rest of Japan. So the peace pass with John Pierre Coupon. Now the crowd enjoys that as Ali, who picked off an attempted blow by Evangelista, pretended to stack. Now Ali is just covering up, as you can see. And Evangelista is trying to score, but he can't get through those gloves of Ali. I suppose this entertains the crowd. Ali got a flicking jab. I can't say it's that amusing. Less than a minute to go in the second round. Ali starts with a left jab. He hasn't thrown really but one combination. He has not been punching hard. And you hear the crowd in unison chanting Ali, Ali.
Counting down the count in the second round.
A combination to the face of Evangelista.
Cicchini, the referee, separates them. As we approach the end of the round, we'll be back in a moment.
The bell for round three. Ali waving come on to Evangelista. Between rounds, brought out the soundtrack. Ali Boumaye, soundtrack from his forthcoming movie, The Great. That, of course, was the victory cry over in Kinshasa, Zaire. That incredible night of October 1974. The combination scores by Ali. Evidently, he can do it as well.
Notice how he can now. Evangelista cannot penetrate those blocks.
Ali playing cover up. No action. Been the same since the fight started. Again, Ali. Well, now beginning to voice its displeasure in the form of boos.
two stars for the couple of jobs. Third one, best job. He can put that job in as well. Finally, the two have one dominant verdict. Remember the old time little one, Rudy Lubers, who went 12 rounds with Ali winning the decision? Evangelista knocked him out in the third round. Lubers must have aged enormously between fights. One of those blows got through. Not one. It cannot penetrate the defense at all. We're approaching the end of the third round. Gene Gilroy, part of Ali's retinue, sitting next to me, is screaming, "Close it up, champ." He's getting embarrassed. Coming to the end of round three. We'll be back. Alfredo Evangelista, at the very opening of this show, a couple of hours ago, I said that Evangelista had dreams of being another bounding bat. And I reminded old-timers of a man named Carolina Huskin, who was a tough fighter, maybe the best ever to come from Spain. At this point, there is probably no resemblance between the two. I count this a bad scene. Here we go again with the rope-a-dope and the cover-up, the tactic employed so effectively against George Foreman. When Ali, fighting to regain the championship, revealed once again that perhaps his greatest strength after all the years was the ability to absorb punishment, to take the punch. Foreman punched himself out, Ali did away with him in the eighth round. The crowd is now booing the absence of action, particularly the absence of any real offensive action by Ali. Even at that, Ali not shot, missing the right the way he did. Remember, this is his first fight since September 28th last. Evangelista with a wide sweeping left only touched Ali's glove. We'll be back in just a moment. The bell for round five. Well, I always thought the best pair of male dancers I ever saw were the Nicholas Brothers a number of years back. Oh, manifestation of Ali throwing a punch or two in this round. Let's see if he goes back to the rope-a-dope and the cover-up. Wild right uppercut got in from Evangelista. Actually got it. Did no damage. Ali sticks and moves a bit, and then against the ropes, covers up. When you think of those three classic fights against Frazier, when you think of Zaire, when you think of the three fights against Norton, it doesn't make you feel good to see the heavyweight title at stake in a thing like this. Released in August of 66 when he's been away with the right hand gets excited. Suddenly, it's Evangelista firing level, but still doesn't get through. They get excited at the mere thought that Evangelista is the apparent offensive man at the moment. This is how it's saying. Ali put away Brian London in the third round. We're coming to the end of this, the fifth round. We'll be back. That's Ali in his corner. Bell for the sixth round is sounding. Apart from Ali's clowning up to this point, which especially did in the early rounds, the only thing he's shown that is kind of a remnant of the past is the quick flicking jab. The clowning can go only so far. You have to wonder how much this man really has left as a fighter. Because if he's out of retirement, which he is, he owes one thing for sure. He owes either Jimmy Young or Kenny Norton a fight. The public has a right to expect that fight if Ali is going to collect big money out of retirement. I remember September of 66 when Ali had trouble with Mildenberger, the German southpaw. And Mildenberger felt so proud. I suspect Evangelista is beginning to feel proud too. But Mildenberger was a difficult fighter. He was a southpaw. Southpaws give Ali trouble. And he was very game. There's a good effort. That's Evangelista. Going level, but not getting through. We'll advise our stations that we'll have a station break at the end of this round. Wow, amateurish left. Angelista's nose is bleeding. That comes from Ali's flicking left. Even at this late stage of Ali's career, you have to wonder what would happen to Evangelista if Ali went to work. Seeing Ali miss with those lefts over the challenger's head, can see how he's nearly as sharp as once he was. Counting down, end of the round. We'll return after this from our local station. That was the bell for the start of round seven. Ali against Evangelista. Ali hardly needs identification. Watching this starting line develop, you have to begin to wonder how much, if anything, Ali can do anymore. Because at this point in time, as a matter of self-respect, you would have expected him to do something. Look at this. Cicchini, the referee. Ali had made a brief complaint. Now trying to climb it up. I don't like this, and I'm sorry. Frankly, that it's on the air. Just had a repeat of an old scene. It happened in the Ron Lyle fight. It happened in the Jimmy Young fight. Ali's brother, Rahman, just came up right behind us, yelled to Muhammad, Ali, you're blowing it. You're blowing it. He's not blowing it. Now, a couple of rounds might be given, in my judgment, to Evangelista, merely on offensive effort. The basic truth is, that Ali has used the left jab in most rounds to score whatever scores have been made, and they've been precious few, the truth. You remember the glorious fighting machine that Muhammad Ali once was. You see this. Maybe the thriller in Manila was the greatest fight I ever saw. Frazier, apparently in command after the 10th round. the resurgence of Ali. And as he put it, it was the closest thing to death. And Joe couldn't come out for the 15th. What a battle. That fighter is going through this now.
Got a slow motion scene to show you. Evangelista scoring with the left. Ali had his right way down. And it's done, Ali. This is the right now, would you believe? Ali is proving in this bout is that it's a long, long jump from September to May. As May comes, May's no longer. So this is the ninth round. You see those wild amateurs left. Evangelist is the champion of the quarter of Ali's opponent. And we have no intent to denigrate the young man. He's had an opportunity to pick up a big table. He threw the top left of Evangelista, but it did not score. Coming to the end of the ninth round. We'll be back in just a moment. We're coming into round 10.
Jerry would like to do away with him now, but you saw that wild missing right. Jimmy Young is in the audience. I think he would love to have a little bit of Ali tonight. One left jab, and then another. Not the jab off the jab, but one blow at a time. That was the third. Not combinations. It's a hand off his neck, Ali, referee.
Come on.
Don't we have the spectacle of the young fighter from Spain, trains in Segovia, about 70 miles north of Madrid. Beautiful town. Spectacle of him at age 22, chasing Ali all over the ring. Not scoring, but Ali in an exhibition will do so much, I suspect, to undo the whole of what he has done. A reputation as a fighter over the long years. We're approaching the end of the 10th round.
Get off the back. Get off, buddy. Step off him. No holding him.
We'll be back in a moment. Round 11. You don't like to beat an old horse, but this has been dreadful. The wild left of Evangelist has glanced off Ali's neck. The whole thing has become a Spanish silent movie. I have to figure now in the 11th round with the impatience, restiveness of the crowd growing and growing, that if Ali could do anything, he would do it and would have done it by now. Look at Evangelista after Ali. And not a crowd has been most tolerant since Fahegan. Get off. Get back. Come on. Really been lenient. What I was leading up to is you had to suspect off this that there is little if anything left in the great fight that we once knew. Look at him miss. Look at him miss. You remember Muhammad Ali? Coming up to the end of round 11. We'll be back in just a moment. Round 12, believe it or not. And the aggressor, although ineffectually so, is Alfredo Evangelista. Ali has missed again and again and again all night. Occasional scoring with the jab. Evangelista hasn't scored at all. He had one good left that we showed in replay some rounds back. Nothing familiar about this Muhammad Ali. Nothing.
Go home, fight for you. Get off of him, Ali. Get off of him.
The way this fight is going, Evangelista will make the World Boxing Council rating system look good.
Get off, Arlene. Get off his neck. I never had it. Stop punching.
Based upon past experience with them, as that little exercise in journalism proved, this could enable him to move Evangelista up four more spots. Jimmy Young temporarily left the arena because he found the fight unacceptable. We're looking for him. Hope to find him. Get his view of what's been non-transpiring here tonight.
Get off his neck, guy. Get off, buddy. My guy.
You know, Ali actually looks tired. He really does, Chris. He looks tired. And what's he done?
What a job our pictures have done. Pretty difficult to add captions to the pictures. They really tell the story.
Evangelista is certainly winning this round as we approach the end of round 12. Look at the ball right now. He's not connected. They're going to stay here. This is a good round for Evangelista. And Ali looks absolutely exhausted. There can be no more limericks after a performance like this. No reliance on the past. No mythology. As Chris said, the pictures speak for themselves. Look at them.
Art, I think we should be very thankful we had some lighter division bouts that were exciting tonight. Heavyweight division has always been glamorous and exciting, and it's lost a lot of glitter, I think, right here in Maryland once more. He's got three more rounds to get through. Then we'll see. Trying to dance and trying to take the offensive, but backing off as the young gentleman from Spain keeps pursuing. Why he came out of retirement is his personal business. It's conjectured that in spite of all the monies he has made because of the settlement of his matrimonial difficulties, Ali needs more money. But the way this thing is gone. He landed a good right there and he hit Evangelista. Evangelista was hurt, but the kid has courage. From the beginning, he was unafraid. It was as if he sensed that he wasn't facing the Muhammad Ali of the past. Well, it keeps acting. The left didn't land, but it was picked off, but he keeps after him. Believe me, last round, a lot of them left. That missed it. Less than a minute to go in the 13th round. How do you think they're scoring this, you folks at home? What do you think, Chris?
Well, I have Evangelista winning three rounds, 7, 8, and 12.
I think you're probably right. They call Louis Firpo the wild bull of the Pampas. The only difference was Louis was good enough to knock Dempsey out of the ring at the old bowling grounds back in 1924. Look at that, Evangelista scored that. Okay, approaching the end of the round. We're about ready for the start of round 14, a perfectly endless fight. I use that word in quotes. Give Evangelista all the credit in the world. He's been a pursuing fighter. He was unafraid coming in. What I've tried to point out is that he is not a quality fighter. It's questionable that he should have been running 10th, but we showed you how that rating came about. And one would have thought that against such an opponent, Ali had more left than he appears to have based upon this performance. Wonder how he's going to try to explain this away. You can see that Ali is doing the scoring. Oh,
Chris said he's given Evangelista three rounds. I've given him four. Who knows, though, Chris, the fight we've been through in judges. The way a fight is gone for 37 months and years.
This is so badly bad.
Coming up to the end of the round. Okay, that's the end of the flushing round. We'll be back in just a moment. All right. We're back for the 15th and final round. And Ali sat down, and I mean he was fatigued. And he is fatigued. And there's no laughter in his eyes, and there can't be any joy in his heart. Not after this, tonight. Fight is just love, great, for the 15th and final round. And Ali would like to rescue some vestige of self-respect here. Sticking with the left. Sticking with the left. One punch at a time. Left got in. Three of them separately. A fourth. A fifth. The right keeps missing. The timing so off. The reflexes so slow. Evangelista keeps pursuing. Trying to connect. A combination there by Ali. A combination for a thing. A 1-2. Ali, as you can see visibly, although he now dances on his toes, he drooped in that corner for just a moment. Catch your breath. Let's start. Evangelista is trying now to beat him, to out-muscle him with his body, to push through the cover-up. Far differently from the way most fighters work. A good left by Ali. Well, the crowd rises. Evangelista. He missed one, landed one. They're counting down to the end of this inglorious affair. Now it is over. Evangelista has gone the distance against Muhammad Ali as the fans pull to distraction. And Evangelista's gonna play a hugging. Heaven knows, maybe they think he's won the fight. Heaven knows, when they score it, maybe he will have won the fight. I've been around too long. But I'll tell you, what we saw was an exercise in torpor, not to be believed. Let me go into the ring and see if I can get an explanation from Ali. Please cover for me, Christian.
Okay, Howard, tough night for you.
Tough
night for Muhammad Ali. Couldn't put it together. 35 years old, shell of what he was. I'm sure you all agree. But this man, 22 years old, can be very happy. He went 15 rounds in the World Championship. Had little to offer, pretty enough. Nevertheless, he was a huge underdog. 7-1, 8-1, 9-1, whatever.
We don't see any results.
Are now having a little trouble getting up as the other corner is directly above us here. And it is really crowded. Despite his performance, he draws that crowd still. And if you'll join us, we'd like to tell you that earlier, an exciting bout, an 8-round knockout for the World Junior Lightweight Champion, Alfredo Escobar, over Becerro. And then the World Lightweight Champion, Roberto Duran, won a unanimous 10-round decision over Javier Muniz. But right now, Howard working his way, trying to get to the champion. As we wait for the decision here, it'll be Harry Cicchini, the referee, and the two judges to the left and the right as you watch the fight with us, Terry Moore and Ray Claymore. A lot of pushing and shoving. Ali wanted to leave the ring early, but was called back. Spanish radio would love to get at him. ABC television would like to get a comment from him, but I doubt if he's in too much of a talkative mood. Now, the decision.
Here is the decision. Terry Moore has it 72-64, Ali.
72-64, Terry Moore. Ali.
Klingmeier has it 72-64, Ali. Cicchini has it 71-65, Ali. Winner, unanimous decision, still heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali.
His 56th professional fight. He now has won 54. Here's Howard.
As you can see, I have a very tired champion here.
First of all, I want to say, Assalamu alaikum to Chief Minister. He lives in Islam, and he lives in the West. I'm the wise in the Hamid. Also, to my main man, Tom Johnner. He's a WWE jockey, and the great speed race.
Now we've got to get down to cases. What do you say? What do you have to say? Because you have been, in the view of many of us, the greatest fighter who has yet lived. What do you say about your performance tonight?
I say that I fought a man who will be a top contender. Just like Ken Law was not out of the fight, Law was no better. The girls and the hypocrites of Boston, the great fighters such as Foreman, Bobby, don't feel like the paper wheel, but I know it's always a tough fight. I'm so thankful for the fight that man put up. Law, no, not, he is no better. And I promise you, he will go along with Martin than Bobby. What about that nobody song tonight?
Well, I didn't see.
Hear that music? Call me Pitches. 19 this month. The last time just come to my movie. All of you go out to see my movie.
Right. Please put me out of bloods for a moment.
No, you blood me out of my blood myself.
All right. Now listen. You've got to be honest and fair with yourself as well as with the public. Your reflexes weren't what they used to be tonight.
No heavyweight. I didn't mess 22 or more and dance 15 rounds like I did. So I'm not what I used to be. To show you I'm a legend, the greatest fight in history. Raw, 5'9", 35, fat as you say. Still, I can outdance any heavyweight in the history of boxing. This shows I'm going to pass them on.
All right.
Getting there. I danced through the whole fight.
Leaving aside your performance tonight.
And you all know that I'm supposed to be able to duck that issue. How good I danced.
Not ducking any issue. At this point in time, if you're going to fight again,
You've got to fight either young or not. You all the money.
I'm on the mat. Trying to get out of shape. You know he's out there jumping the ball. Trying to make a dollar come for the defender. The World Boxing Association has told me that what I say is right. Martin and Young have to remedy each other to prove they're number one. Because Jimmy Young beat George Foreman, who is the legal number one defender. He's ranked over there. People want me to fight both of them.
Let's go back to Chris Schenkel at ringside.
And again, repeating, 71-65, 72-64, 72-64, 5-point must system, unanimous decision. No encounter for the champion. Time of arrangement, stay tuned, a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. Fly the friendly skies of United, for you're the boss. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as a leader in sports television.
With great fighters such as Foreman, Babbage, don't go like you think.
Muhammad Ali!
His 56th professional fight. He now has won 54 of his heart.
As you can see, I have a very tired champion here.
First of all, I want to say, Islam Aleikum, the chief minister, and Islam and leaders, and Islam and the wealth, and the wise and Muhammad. Also to my main man, Tom Jana, who's the deputy UN Jagdishakamah, and the great speed race, the red demand.